here at VREC 2020. Steve Darling and Proactive. And joining me now is Paul Wood, the CEO of BTU Metals. And Paul, great to see you. How are you?
Very well, thanks. Thanks for having me.
Enjoying the conference so far?
It's been super busy, eh? It has been busy. We've had very little downtime.
Well, a lot of people have been coming by and saying they want to know a little bit more about you. You're in the Red Lake area, and your neighbor has been doing some pretty good stuff for the last little while, that being Great Bear. So tell me a little bit about your project.
Well, we have about 200 square kilometers of property. We pretty much surround and are contiguous to Great Bear Resources.
Yeah.
We have two primary targets in our property so far. One's called the Dixie Creek target, which is a continuation of the Great Bear trend, the LP findings that they get coming towards the southeast. So we've identified that structure on our ground. So that's a high-grade gold target.
Okay.
We also have another target called the TNT target, which is further to the south, which is totally different geology.
Okay.
And it looks to be the edge of a potentially very large VMS system.
Yeah. So there's been some work done on this, obviously, previously. I know you're drilling right now, and we can talk about that in a second, but what's been done previously on that?
This is not a very heavily explored area. Even Great Bears was not. We only had 20 holes on our property when we took it over. We've since put about, I think I just heard from the field, I think they just finished hole 26. In the TNT area, we hit with our 13th hole, and that's where we got 44 meters of over 1% copper equivalent. The highlights within those being intervals of 5.5% copper, 2 grams gold, 3 ounces of silver.
Wow.
So we're very excited about that area. It's a very large area identified by VTEM and IP at 200 meter intervals. It looks like 200 to 500 meters wide east-west and over a kilometer north-south. So the guys are back working right now.
Yeah, and so that will that be the focus then for 2020? Is this particular area, or do you want to sort of continue with both?
We are going to absolutely continue with both. We are probably about 6 or 7 holes further into TNT right now. 5 or 6 of those are probably in the lab by now, and we're awaiting results anytime. Red Lake's one of those great areas where you can pretty cost-effectively drill all year round.
Yeah.
Up in the Dixie Creek area, right near Great Bear, where you can almost see their drills turning, we are waiting on SGH samples, which is a surface sampling technique that they've been using in order to hone in on where to drill on along that continuity of LP. So when we get those back, we'll be going up there as well.
Is that make a good advantage when you have someone like a Great Bear, and there are others there as well in Red Lake that are doing really well, in knowing their geology as it's sort of following that trend down? Has that been a big advantage?
It absolutely does. The mag looks the same on their side and our side, so they provide a bit of a roadmap. Of course, the guys in the field, they bump into each other up there, and they, you know, they share some good information every once in a while, and it provides a excellent roadmap, especially in an underexplored area. That's how we knew to go with the SGH surveying. They explain in their press releases and personally how effective it's been at honing where to drill. So that's the map. We'll do that, and we'll drill just like they did, and hopefully get the same kind of numbers.
There you go. Well, we'll look forward to hearing more about the story. Great to meet you. Thank you very much for being here.
Good to meet you. Thank you.
All right. Paul Wood, the CEO of BTU Metals.